the question of cowboy computer repairs. That's what I do. And I don't mean it as any kind of compliment, because the way Brian showed you how to replace a CPU is the correct way. However, the way I like to do it isn't even unplugging the stuff from the computer. The most I'll unplug from the computer when I'm changing a CPU or putting in RAM is just the power plug. Leave the rest in place. I don't want to have to go through all the wires and back and put them together again. I'd rather be super uncomfortable and a little cramped position in the back of the house like I am here to work on this old Dell Dimension 2400. Now, what it has in it is an already upgraded CPU. It came with the Celeron 1.8, I think. And so the first upgrade I did was to Pentium 4 2.6. However, that one had a 512 level 2 cache. The Celeron had a 128 level 2 cache, so four times the difference. Well, on eBay, I picked up Pentium 4 hyperthreading capable CPU, which means it can fool the thing into acting like a dual core CPU, even though it's only one core. That's a 2.8, and it has twice as much L2 cache. It has a megabyte L2 cache. So, putting that in, plus upgrading the RAM, it currently has two sticks, one 512, one 256, so it has a total of 768. I'm going to take out the 256, put in a 512, it'll have a gigabyte of RAM and 2.8 hyper-threading CPU with 1 megabyte L2 cache. But I don't like to do it by laying the computer flat, like Brian said, which is the right way to do it. Get that sucker laid flat, and you work on it like a surgeon with a patient on a table. Very much agree. Hard to do this with one hand. Okay. So, I should add, by the way, that when I got the CPU, it was on eBay for $7 and change. And unlike the Arctic Silver that Brian got, I got little packets of very basic thermal compound for what amounted to 50 cents a packet. So I got, a couple of milligrams for $2 shipped. Okay, so this stuff here is easy. There's a little hook around the side here that keeps the sucker in. Okay, so the shield over the fan swings open like a door. And it's been a while since I've worked on this particular one, but I have a pretty good idea of what's going to happen next. The heatsink here is over the CPU, and there's a couple of clamps on top and bottom. So we're going to have to spring those clamps, take out the heatsink, and then pull the lever to release the CPU. I wonder if I could get a neat little angle going here as this thing is pulled. Okay, so there's basically a retention clamp there. Take that out, and there's another similar retention clamp on top. And we're going to take that. Okay, two retention clamps are out. And this old boy here has a couple of clips keeping it in place. Folks, that was almost where I started crying. About 2 full minutes have passed. At least it seemed like that way. All right. Now, back of this thing has ages worth of thermal grease on it. We're gonna put a little more. Ain't gonna clean that shit up. No way. Put alcohol. I ain't no crazy bastard. You think I'm clean and thorough? All right, so there's the CPU. Let's see, what kind of view do you have of it? You have a view of it? Oh, there you go. All right, so popping this baby out, lifting this little lever on the side here, and plucking it out like a ripe fruit. Yes. All right. Old one. And I'm wrapping the new one and putting the thermal grease on it, so I'll be back in a second. Okay, got a dab of schmutz in that thing. And we just want it to find its way in there. Make sure that it has. You're right, you're tight, you're comfortable. And we'll close the locking bar. Now to get the heatsink back on. Want to make sure things are cool. That boy up there. That boy in there. Have we got it? A little double check never hurts. There, snap. Snappity snap. How do you like them apples, huh? Now the memory is one of the easier aspects of dealing with this here monster. So I'm gonna do it with an obscured view and one hand. And watch me fumble. Watch my unsure movements as I try to get it in the slot. Remind me when I was a young man. So when it's in, you'll hear a snippity snap. At least you should. One, two. It should have been two, right? There you go, two. Okay, well, that means your memory's installed. Put the shield back over the heatsink. That in. These are really pretty easy to work with. Working with Dells. Yeah. Working with Dells is cool. Alright, so we're going to put the side of the case back on, plug her back in, and see if she explodes.